Hi, I'm Mark from Microsoft. The foundational pillars of any security incident management framework are to identify and contain threats quickly, investigate threats thoroughly, mitigate and notify affected parties. Microsoft's incident management process is built around achieving each of these pillars. Our process is constantly evolving to address the newest and emerging threats. We incorporate our learnings from prior incidents, and it provides a framework for continuous improvement of processes and response times. Microsoft operates within a shared responsibility model to define security and operational accountabilities. We provide many capabilities to evaluate and strengthen the security posture of customer-managed environments. This video will walk you through how Online Services investigates, manages, and responds to security concerns. Our incident management program is a critical responsibility. It's paramount that our customers' data is secure and protected, and our investment in us process ensures this. In the online service terms, Microsoft defines a security incident as a confirmed breach of security leading to the accidental or unlawful destruction, loss, alteration, unauthorized disclosure of, or access to customer data or personal data while processed by Microsoft. Microsoft implements a federated security response model. All major online service workloads have dedicated security response teams with specialized engineering skills. But each team adheres to a shared incident management process, shared definitions, and shared training. This response model provides consistency across all online services while supporting deeper engineering specialization. In the event of a security incident, Microsoft will promptly and without undue delay notify an impacted customer, investigate and provide our customer with detailed information about the security incident, and take reasonable steps to mitigate the effects and to minimize any damage resulting from the security incident. This response commitment is aligned with industry standards and conforms to legal and regulatory requirements such as GDPR and HIPAA. Microsoft's Security Incident Management Program is closely modeled after the guidance from the National Institutes of Standards and Technology, who's also known as NIST. NIST Standard 861 defines the incident response phases as preparation, detection and analysis, containment, eradication and recovery, and post-incident activity. Let's dive into the first phase, preparation. We devote significant resources to preparing for incidents before they occur. Multiple times throughout the year, each Microsoft online service tests their respective incident response capabilities. Each online service develops and maintains an up-to-date incident response plan. The plan provides a framework for assigning severity and categorization of incidents. It also provides guidance for addressing each category of incident and a high-level approach for how teams respond. This plan is updated annually at a minimum. To ensure we stay ahead of even the most determined adversaries, Microsoft regularly conducts red and blue team cybersecurity exercises. The red team consists of Microsoft cybersecurity experts who constantly attempt to breach our own production services without being detected in order to simulate attacks by advanced adversaries. Our blue team is a group of highly skilled cyber defenders that use sophisticated security tools and techniques to detect and defeat the red team's efforts. Following each exercise, full transparency and collaboration across these teams helps uncover potential weaknesses. By breaking down teams' organizational silos and sharing knowledge, Microsoft is able to better protect, detect, and respond to security events. Red team versus blue team exercises are performed both at enterprise level and service component level throughout the year. Many key security investments result from findings and recommendations of previous penetration tests, vulnerability assessments, and incidents. In addition, all Microsoft employees must undergo annual training related to information security issues, which helps them identify and report suspected security matters. Further, employees who require access to the service undergo additional security and privacy training to maintain eligibility for access to the service annually. Now let's talk about phase two, detection and analysis. Online services teams focus on key threat scenarios and complementary detection and analysis activities to enable security response to begin as early in the attack lifecycle as possible in order to provide ample information from which to make response actions effective and efficient. Incidents may be detected through many different means, with varying levels of detail and fidelity. Automated detection capabilities include network-based and host-based intrusion detection prevention systems, antivirus software, and log analyzers. Incidents may also be detected through manual means, such as problems reported by end users directly. Based on the indications and observations leading to the incident initiation, a preliminary scope of impact is determined. Then data is analyzed and investigated upon collection. The most serious result of detection and analysis is the discovery that customer data has been disclosed, modified, or destroyed. If Microsoft becomes aware of a breach of security leading to the accidental or unlawful destruction, loss, alteration, unauthorized disclosure of, or access to customer data or personal data, our customer security incident notification process is initiated immediately to provide impacted customers with accurate, actionable, and timely notice when their data has been breached while meeting all legal and compliance requirements. Now let's talk about how we mitigate a threat in phase three: containment, eradication, and recovery. The primary goal of containment activities is to limit the harm to Microsoft systems, applications, and customers and their data. After an incident or breach has been detected, it is important to contain the intrusion before the adversary can access more resources or cause additional damage. In order to minimize the risk and increase our ability to respond quickly, Microsoft utilizes various automated response capabilities as a part of our overall response efforts. Eradication is the process of eliminating the root cause of the security breach with a high degree of confidence. The goal is twofold: to evict the adversary completely from the hosting environment, and to mitigate the vulnerability that had or could enable the adversary to re-enter the environment based on the analysis performed during the investigation phase. A key aspect to recovery is to have enhanced detection controls in place to validate that the recovery plan has been successfully executed and no signs of breach remain within the environment. A few examples may include added network level monitoring, targeted detections for previously identified attack vectors, or additional vigilance on critical resources. Finally, let's talk about what happens in phase four, post-incident activity. Following eradication and recovery of the service, the team will move into post-incident activities. The post-mortem is aimed to identify technical lapses, procedural failures, manual errors, and other process flaws that might have caused the incident or that were identified during the incident response process. It's also worth noting that not all security incidents will require a full post-mortem activity. Microsoft runs on trust. We are dedicated to protecting and safeguarding our customers' critical data. The thoughtful, responsive security incident procedures we've outlined today are an example of that dedication in practice. This ensures that our customers can continue their work and achieve more. Customers wishing to learn more about the capabilities to improve their security posture of their own environment are encouraged to start by reviewing the security and compliance offerings found within the Tenant Admin Portal. For additional papers and guidance, please visit Service Trust Portal. Thanks for watching.